world where equality is just another euphemism for mediocrity, where participation is more highly valued than achievement, where just enough to get by is the new standard of excellence. There is a small minority of people who fight back against such apathy, who struggle daily to reach new heights. These brave few are the hope for the future, the bright shining light for the next generation. They are the ones who will lead us to the places we have never dreamed of, to the undiscovered country, to reach goals only a few can even begin to imagine. Unfortunately, none of those people could be here tonight, so kick back and relax. Prepare yourself for several hours of fun, friendship, fascinating conversation, and fabulous music. All those F's, that's an alliteration and kind of a radio trick. Speaking of radio, you're listening to the most popular radio station in the history of broadcast radio, at least among stations that originate from Chris's living room. It's Curious Times. Your host is a curious listener. Here she is, Chris.
Hey! Oh, please, no need for the applause. welcome to Curious Times, everybody. It is Saturday, September 3rd, and three balls up. That's the temperature in Edmonton is three balls up. That means it's getting colder. Getting colder. Three balls up. See how I freeze. Just to let you know, in the wintertime, when my furnace is working, when I'm unsure if my furnace is working, if the third ball is up, I go, uh-oh, the furnace is not kicking in. So if I had my furnace turned on right now, it would be on. And this would be down here. But so anyway, three balls cold, man. And, let me just give me a second here. Kate, and so we do have Kimber here. Yay, it's been feels like forever. You know what I mean? Since Kimber's been here, but she is here. Present and accounted for. It's long weekend for most people, I guess, and so Labor Day long weekend, and so I guess we can still pretend this is like a Friday night or something like that. Of course, I put in an order for some e-liquid, but didn't until late Thursday sometime. Got the notice Friday that it would parcel was already like in Calgary. And so if I would have ordered one day sooner, I might have had my stuff. But now I won't get it till Wednesday probably because they don't do mail on weekends here and it's Monday's a holiday. So Tuesday it'll make its way from Calgary to Edmonton and then Wednesday it'll come by. The dude will come on Wednesday. So anyway, if I would have been one day sooner with that. I always seem to do that too, which is to order on an approaching long weekend. Figure it out, Chris. Okay, Kimber's here. We had a great show last night, if any of you guys missed it, with Jenny Satori, Rockin' the Runes. And so you can feel free to go check that out in archives if you so choose. Awesome. You're getting it on a Sunday? You're getting a package on a Sunday. Wow. Never ever on a Sunday, our mail doesn't come. Okay, anyway, that's the same with when I was in like weekends or when I was in England. They're all like, I go, you got like mail coming on the weekend? Craziness. What kind of craziness and madness is this? Anyway, what else is coming up this week? Sunday, tomorrow, Hillary Black. Monday, Nick Fox. Tuesday, Lisa Nolan Shalosky. Wednesday, Barbara DeLong. Thursday, Jen Young. And then next Friday, maybe a night off and maybe EBPs, but maybe numerology. Maybe numerology again. I have to think out what we'll do numerology on your pets. Find out when your pets' birthdays were. I'm just kidding. We'll just do whatever. You know what I mean? And there you go. That is what's going on at Curious Times in the next week, we hope. And so, but tonight, Kimber's here. She's a mystery woman. She likes to shroud herself in mystery. And I think it was 16 and a half years ago, she promised to send me a picture or something like that. It was a give or take a decade, you know. But anyway, I'm teasing. I totally teasing. She's a clairvoyant, a psychic medium, a healer. She reads auras, energy, animals, you name it. She's very much an empath. She uses cards, stones, bones, bone reader right here at Curious Times. And she also is a medium, so she can communicate with crossed over people. And she can get, angel guides, animal guides, you name it. She can do psychometry. She got all of this, like, working a lot stronger for her after her near-death experience. And she really does just want to help people. You'll see that if we only have a couple of callers, then those callers are going to get, like, 40-minute readings because Kimber doesn't stop. If Kimber did this for a living, she would go broke because she'd get somebody on at 9 o'clock in the morning, and like by supper time, the person on the other end would be going, I gotta go get supper on for my husband now, but thanks a lot for your reading, you know. And so I time manage based on how many people are actually in the queue waiting. And so if there's only a couple, then I'm going to just like let her go, and I'm going to like get into a different window and play Candy Crush or something like that. You know what I mean? So if you guys mean to get in for a reading, get in earlier than later. And let's mosey on over there and see what. And you can find Kimber on Facebook at Kimberly Psychic Medium 1. And that's the number 1. And so here comes Kimber.
Hey, hi.
How's it going?
Good. Hi. How are you?
Long time no see.
Yes, I know. Way too long. I've missed you so much. Missed everyone. I'm sorry that you ended up having to do the show if you were tired and not feeling well.
I didn't have to do anything. I did not have to do anything.
No.
Like, I knew once I would just, like, give, you know, I was just in that moment. And you know what? It's because I was hurting, you know, my back and collarbone and all this kind of, and I was just like, and I was, like, doing that, like, my eyes are not all the way awake, and so I could just, you know, go back to sleep, and I'm like, nah. And then, but once I'm up, that's it. If I'm up for longer than it takes to go pee, then I'm up for the count. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you know, if you ever have to or you want to, you know, definitely. And I know, I feel you're really sore and really tired. You need more sleep, and I feel that pain in your lower back. You have been really feeling it lately. I feel so bad.
Enough about me. What have you been doing? What's going on? What do you want to talk about? Who do you want to talk
about? Well, we can talk about whatever. There's several different things. I have been busy, a lot of just kind of catching up and getting stuff done for the summer. I can't believe how fast it's just been flying by, and just trying to get caught up, helping some friends going through some issues and doing some healing too. Just been super drain myself too, so I completely understand how you're feeling right now, because there comes a time where sometimes we just get really, really drained. But yeah, just been doing lots and lots trying to get caught up and cleaning out a storage unit and just tons of stuff. It's hard to believe, though, that it's already September, fall coming up quick, and I'm sure you're probably not looking forward to that because I know you end up with such cold weather very soon.
Already, the other day I saw yellow, a couple of yellow leaves. Now there's more. Before you know it, it's three balls up. You know what I mean? And it's already so it's cold. Three balls up equals chilly. What is the temperature even? I don't even look at the temperature number wise anymore. So here in my house right now, right based on this thing, is 72 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah.
It's actually not bad, let's see, what's the outside temperature? Edmonton weather. Edmonton, 52 Fahrenheit. It's 52 Fahrenheit out there, 11 degrees Celsius outside. 52 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's getting there.
Yeah. Fall weather already.
Slow, long decline. But hopefully we'll have Indian winter.
Yeah.
Indian summer.
Indian summer.
Cut my tongue out. Indian winter, if that means longer winter. I'm so not playing.
Yeah, you threw me for a minute, but I went along with it.
whoa, back up the truck, man. Back up the truck.
Maybe it was something I didn't know about. It is coming up very, very quick, definitely. Planning for all that. So I was going to ask you, too, about what your opinion is. I keep seeing all this posting about oil protest and, how they're trying to do so much to prevent all of this pipelines, and I know that they did a lot over there in Canada as well, and that they're doing a lot here in North Dakota, and it just seems so tragic.
This here's the I get a little torn with it. First of all, my, default position is if I had it my way, all these wealthy oil companies would reinvest their money into non-renewable resource. So into solar energy panels, for example, and solar energy solutions. And then they can sell us that at an extraordinarily exaggerated price, as they do with gasoline, but they could. So that's the default position. Having said that, it tends to bring jobs and all this kind of stuff. I'm not all in favor of someone's land has to get torn. You know what I mean? Here in Canada, what would happen is that in consultation and, the idea became for the Aboriginal people that the oil companies need to do more than offer ditch digging, menial, low-level jobs to the native people, to the Aboriginal people, and that there needs to be a more meaningful benefit to them, et cetera, and et cetera. And so, all in all, it's true to say wherever there's pipelines, there's going to be leaks and all of that kind of stuff, but but on the other side of that, until we have a more cost-effective solution on it, we do need fuel for our homes and our cars. What I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm not rich enough right now. It's all well and good enough for me to say how, but I'm not certainly rich enough to be able to swap out my house and make it a solar home, and I'm not rich enough to go and buy a vehicle that would be solar powered or what other kind of other power, so I'm not one to, that's the catch-22 that we sometimes get caught up in,
Oh, yeah, definitely. And that's a very valid point.
Because all those people get into their big ass res trucks. You know what I mean? Their res trucks drive to the picket line where they're protesting. Then you got to say, like, then you're using the fuel. You know, you cannot boycott, like, we had a boycott up over here and against a place called Gainers or whatever, food processing plant, eh? And I'm all like, they're, so these big chest-thumping, button-popping Neanderthals that I worked with, they would be all, boycott, and they'd go and have their bacon and eggs or something like this, right? And so, like, you got people that are, like, barking up. Somebody accidentally unmuted themselves. You know what I mean, Kimber?
Yeah. Oh, definitely. You know, I completely agree with you. It's, there isn't much of an alternative. It's so many different opinions. There's, you know, so many different ways. A lot of people are really torn over it. It just seems kind of a very difficult and endless battle, and there really is not much of a solution either way. It's kind of a difficult, very difficult thing, and as you said, there really isn't an alternative and not an affordable one for most people, and it is what it is, you know. You know, you just kind of have to hope for the best and hope that it's the most cost-effective and, you know, the least damaging what is done and what they do. But it's a very sad situation all around, you know.
It's
just seems...
a sad situation.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. I know. I have to pretty much stay off of Facebook because a lot of it is just, you know, hard.
Now you got me.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. You really, that's your fault.
I know it is. My bad. I know sometimes songs get stuck in my head and I'll post them just to get rid of them. You know, to share them. Because, yeah.
I know.
You get...
It's craziness. Well,
yeah.
You know, well, you know, I mean, if you've listened, you already know that I'm afflicted with that disease, so.
Yeah.
Which is that if somebody utters the words of us in a song, then I must break out in song. It must be part of my blueprint. And even if I was in a work meeting, you know what I mean? I would sing my next my answer or whatever. You know what I mean? Crazy.
Yeah.
Is anybody here? Blah, blah, blah. No, 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 no. You know what I mean? Anyway, I'm ridiculous.
You're good at it, though. You'd be so great at Name That Tune and Remember That Old Show.
Probably.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be good at Name That Tune because, well, the funny thing about how my brain works, and many of our brains actually, but you know, is... I don't know if this happens to you guys too, but like I know Heath is awesome. He can hear a few notes of a song. He can know who did it and what the title is. Not me, but as the song starts to play, then the lyrics come into my head. They don't come in advance. Like I get the lyrics as the song goes. You know what I mean? So sometimes like I am useless at the just hear a few notes because I won't get to the song title until the song develops to that. It's just strange how my brain works that way. I mean, there's obviously very well-known songs or favorite songs of mine that I know right away and everything like that. But so I would totally suck at Name That Tune, really suck at it. Like I could probably sing a line of a song, but not tell you what the song's title is or... But I would know who it is, but it's just scrambled up there in my brain in such a way that it's only coming out in its own time.
Yep.
time.
Yep, exactly.
I don't know that I can get rid of a song, but I do know that when somebody puts a song, gets a song stuck in my head, I love to return the favor. And I usually try to pick the most annoying song that I can. You know what I mean? So it's like I the opposite. It is a song that never ends. It goes on and on, my friend.
Yeah, like the Barney song, you know.
Yeah, like Barney song. Oh, poor Stan. Gonna have to get over it, Stan.
Sorry, Stan. I'll put one in your head. One I absolutely hate. I cannot stand is somebody.
Just mind him singing, you know? That's his problem. He must sing. He does not like emotion.
Well, there's always those certain songs, and one I hate so much is somebody I used to know. That one drives me nuts.
I love doing that. I'm Henry the Eighth, I am Henry the Eighth, I am, I got married to the widow next door. She's been married 7 times before.
I like that song.
I'm Henry the Eighth, the second verse, same as the first. I'm Henry the Eighth, I am Henry the Eighth, I am. You can thank Heath for that one, you guys. You can all like go and pound on Heath over there. And
yeah, thanks, Heath. That is a good one, though. Mike and Nick used to play that on their show a lot.
Mike and
Nick Humphreys and Mike Davies.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, and they'd play that song, and so that one would get stuck in my head quite often. Thanks, guys. It's back now.
I didn't even know you went to that show. Do you still check out any shows on Broken Talk?
Oh, gosh, that was years ago, and Nick's a good friend, and Mike is actually too, but I don't really go to...
Sometimes people would hit me up on Skype and go, oh, are you there? Like, or someone like Rihanna or something like this. And she'd be all like, they're having trouble over at their show because I was the go-to tech person. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you're good.
You know, there were times when Rihanna or somebody like that would, or for any other show for that matter. But that was one I recall being summoned to. And, I'll be right there. I had to put my costume on first, you know what I mean? And so, yeah. Yeah.
You got some superpowers. You're good.
Sure. If I had superpowers, I'll tell you, there'd be something that would be different in my life, but that's okay. How's anybody and everybody who happens to be in storm area? I didn't check up on the storm progress here today. It was battering the Carolinas, and I guess they're saying that could be kicking around all the way till Wednesday up there on the East Coast, eh?
Just some crazy weather. Wow.
Well, it's hurricane. You know what I mean? Yeah. I guess it's not, like, that would be like saying it's crazy that, oh, my God, it's snowing on Christmas Day in Edmonton. That's crazy weather we got.
that's so odd.
Oh, my God, the world is going to end, you know? And,
like, what the hell? No, it just seems like a lot of places have just been having really different weather, though, and kind of difficult times, and it has been one of the hottest summers too for so many. You know, it's hard to say what's really happening.
Earthquake?
Yeah. Scary. scary. A lot of things happen.
That's why. See, you guys? See, I've said this before, like, without knowing why, I get very lethargic and achy and hurting and when there's natural stuff going on. So there.
Yes. You pick it up. You feel it. You're a very, very strong empath, and you also are psychic. I know you always fight that one, but you are, and you pick up a lot.
Calling. No need for name calling.
Yeah, I'm sorry. You know I say it because I love you. Oops. That one too. I use the L word.
What are you trying to do? Get kicked off my show? Is that what you're trying to do? Anyway,
I know. All that's left is to cry, right? You're going to mute me.
There you go. Perfect. Okay. Linda is in queue. We had some, and then Jay with the last name that starts with R. I should know who that is, but I can't remember anymore who these people. I used to easily remember, it's just that the problem here is that normally the people, the phone, the names that show up together, then I don't get phone numbers that show up, right? I get names.
Yeah.
And then usually the name that shows up on there is not the name that the person uses in chat. So it messes my head up. Before, it was easy for me to associate a telephone number with a name in chat. You know what I mean? But here, I'm just totally, totally hooped with who the hell, I don't know who's here. And then we got us somebody that's last first name starts with an A and the last name starts with an S. And that only means that the person who pays the phone bill, that's whose name shows up, is the person who pays the phone bill, not necessarily the person calling. So we have what I'm trying to say in a long, drawn-out way is that there appears to be three callers right now.
Sure.
And based on curious times math, that means each of them gets will get a half an hour, 20 minutes to half an hour each. So, again, you guys will have to call in if you're going to call in, because don't, like, wait until the last 20 minutes and I'll pile in, because that just adds too much stress. That's what I mean, Sherry. I don't want anyone to wait until, because now I might talk and keep talking and talking, and then people are all like, well, I'm going to wait till she finishes talking before I put my hand up. No, the hand doesn't bother me at all. It actually is informative. And otherwise, I go, I don't have no callers, so I got to keep talking and talking and talking and cut talking, you know? And then if I see like a whole shitload of people lining up, then I go, oh, we got no time to talk. Let's get to it. That's how it works, you guys. So there's some new people here. What do you got ready to go tonight? Everything or what are you doing tonight?
Yeah, pretty much whatever anyone wants, you know, generals, messages, bones, stones, whatever.
Bones, stones, animals, messages, dead people.
Yep.
I like it when people are all like, you got a lot of, oh my God, you know I come from a long line of dead people.
Yes.
Like, really, definitely. Don't we all have a whole bunch of dead people? And I'm betting that every single person in here has a dead great-great-great-grandfather and a great-great-great-grandmother. They're dead. Anyway.
Some might push their way through.
Some might push their way through. And some of them might be some of you. How many of us that are here right now are dead great-great-great-great-grandparents? Every single one of us, probably.
There you go. Yep.
And all of us were, I know that Stan, at least, was an alien before. Might even still be one.
Oh, yeah. Stan is great.
Stan,
he's amazing.
Stan is a great, 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 great grandfather who's still alive.
He has great energy. Stan is yeah, it's very amazing. Very spiritual.
So there we have, I see Mary Margaret just signed into Skype, and so that's good. Got Sherry, Linda, and then the JR, and AS.
Three?
And that's four people. I'm going to go with Sherry, Sherry, then Linda, and then J, and then A, S.
Sure.
And if you don't know who those are, whenever you hear a beep in your ear, I'm unmuting you. That's what that beep is. Oh, it looks like Stan's making a run for it to come on, so that's Stan too. See, it helps me to know, because now I won't let Kimber go for a half an hour on the first person. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I give long ones.
Dorothy's
good at quickies, and I give long ones.
So I'm going to we'll probably be hearing the crickets every 15 minutes or so. And that will allow for some latecomers. Latecomers. I wanted to say hey to Boat Mom. I almost never get to see Boat Mom anymore, and so very nice and cool to see Boat Mom. That must mean, are you on the road again, Boat Mom? You only come here when you got nothing better to do and you're held hostage on the road, or?
Yeah,
I'm going to play
it.
Oh, and PJ's at your desk at home? I feel honored. Honored, I say. Honored. And so I'm going to play song, and then we'll take that, first caller. So go and spin your head around and do whatever else you do to get yourself ready. Haven't played this one in a while. We're going to go with this, and we'll be back in like just under 4 minutes.
As they said farewell. Are you looking for a place to meet like-minded people? Perhaps you're a light worker looking for a safe place to share your thoughts and services. We've got a place for you, intuitalks.com. Join for free, post updates, blogs, create and join groups via website or radio or class package. The possibilities are endless. Join the All Spiritual, all under one roof network, www.intuitalks.com.
All right. Well done, Jenny. Good job on the promo, and very nice. So we're back. Quick shout out. Sherry's there. Amy is not listening, but she's there. Anonymous is me. Beth is there. Hi, Linda is there. Boat Mom, that's another Linda. Boo Boo, Brian, how you doing, Brian? Christy, Stan the Man, Deb in Calgary, Diane in Canada, Heath, Kimber is our guest, and Michelle. Hi, Michelle. And then JR and AS and Terry. Hey, Terry, how are you? And, but yeah, I have some pictures that we might look at in overtime that's on my Facebook page that got put up there by Candy something or Candy. Candy, can't remember her last name at this moment. And it's picture taken by, you know how people who live in the country have these country cameras to catch the wildlife cameras or something like that are motion sensitive. And so she posted an interesting picture, but to me it's like Funk Master Chris. What is Funk Master? What does that mean? Oh, I was a DJ in a previous life. Why, you like the music? Is that it? You like the music? Cool. And so anyway, yeah, this is definitely there's headlights there. It has to be a vehicle, you know, and... interesting, though. Interesting picture. Okay, let me go get Kimber. Hey, Kimber. Kimber! I could go longer. Okay. Sorry, ready to go. I hope that you didn't mean to have a rune reading last night. I was asking before I saw you there. And I hope I didn't skip over you, but I don't know if you heard me when I said, like, press 1-1 right now if you want a rune reading. And I didn't see or hear a 1-1, so I scooted over you. So I hope I didn't, yeah. I hope you weren't there for a rune reading. But if you were, I apologize.
No, you did great. And Jenny is amazing. And because I had one not that long ago, I wanted to give others a chance because she is awesome. And I do so love to get one from her, and I can't wait till she's on again. So
yeah, well, and I'm not going to push my luck with that. You know what I mean? It's going to be spring or something before I ask her again, you know? And,
yeah.
Really busy, number one. And number two, like I said last night, like she's not one to, you know what I mean? She doesn't really like to have the spotlight on her and all that kind of stuff. I want to walk that it's a special treat every now and then, but not something that she feels like that she's, you know, and not, you know, like that, you know what I mean, hey?
Yes,
like how you,
definitely.
Like you're obligated to do it every other weekend, you know what I mean? And
yeah,
you're not
obligated. Love to. Definitely. And any other time, too, as well. And no, I totally know what you mean. And I'm so honored that I had one from her a while back when she was on. And as much as I'd love to get them because she is so amazing and I love runes very, very much. And I wanted to give others a chance because she is so awesome, and I know it's rare to get a chance to have one with her, and definitely honored and love her. She is so great. She has such a great personality. I know she is a bit shy and kind of doesn't really get out there too much, but when she does, she just really shines. She's such a bright light. She has so much beauty, so much love. She's very, very wonderful soul, very sweet soul. So, yeah, I think it's great when she does come on. It is a special treat.
Right. So now here's the deal, Kimber. Stay on track. Yep. And you got 15 minutes for each person, and I'll speed you up later if I need to, but for now, 15 minutes is lots. And do not ignore my crickets. Like, there's nothing worse than when my crickets get ignored.
I'm so sorry. Yep, I'll be a good girl. I promise I'll be a good girl.
I'm like, no respect for the crickets. You know, the crickets are getting no respect. So here's here's what we're listening for. And that means
yep.
Wrap the F up. Okay? And so
yep, I will.
Well, therefore, I want people to, you know, I know everybody, whatever you pick up. It's like, I pick up that you had a bad hair day today. Thanks for calling. See you later. Okay. Come on, you guys. Put some effort into your questions, yes? And pick up Josh. I picked up a cold. I picked up a cold the other day, but thanks for asking. See ya. Okay. Here comes Sherry. Hi, Sherry.
Hey, Chris.
How are you?
Hey, Sherry.
I'm doing good. Hi, Kimber.
Hi.
Well, I'm going back to work on Tuesday. You know, have to turn back into a pumpkin. I won't be able to come on during the week. Just wanted to see what's in store for the next couple of months as far as work goes.
Sure. Wow. A lot of change, a lot of excitement. Hard work is finally paying off. It seems you've been working very, very hard to get to where you're at right now. And a lot of it's going to finally start to pay off. You are looking forward to change. You need this. You need this growth. It's going to be a wonderful opportunity. I see just you putting so much effort, a lot of learning. It seems like you're learning a lot and some new experience. It almost feels that you're either you have met someone at work or you're going to meet someone at work that's going to be very beneficial, very helpful for you, a very good contact. Going to help you so much to further not only your career but also your personal growth. So if you have that person in mind, if not, watch for that because you're going to find someone that's going to be very, very wonderful for you.
Oh, cool.
As a very good connection. Yeah. And I do feel that coming up very soon. Change. I get a lot of change with you. For some reason, lessons learned keeps coming up. I get lessons learned that you've been through a lot, and you've learned a lot from it. You've grown very, very strong. I get deep strength, high intuition. You're very inspirational, not only to others but to yourself as well. You tend to kind of, if you look on the bright side, the positive side, you do really well. Continue to focus on that because I see every once in a while some, as with all of us, some stuff just gets thrown in your life, and I feel that that's been kind of recent. And you've had just some stuff you've had to deal with, but you've done really well with it. You've looked at it as lessons learned and a positive change. And I almost feel that there's some communication and kind of a different relationship, a change in a relationship, a positive change, a good change, and strength. I get you're working on emotional balance, your inner peace and strength. You've done very well with that. It's something that you've been working really hard with, balance. it's going to get a lot easier because it seems like you've kind of went through some difficult stuff, and that tends to throw us a bit off balance.
Right.
And yeah, and I know you struggled, and I feel it. But I also feel that sometimes it's the really hard things that make us very strong and help us to grow and change and sometimes push us into the positive place that we need to be. And so if you look at it as it was all a growing experience, because I just really feel that you've learned so much, especially the last 3 years seem 3 months, but also 3 years. The last 3 years seem like you've been through a lot of different things, a lot of changes.
Yeah.
A lot of personal growth, a lot of emotional things, a lot of letting go. Good job. Because okay. I really feel that. I feel that it's so important. That's something that I tell many people very often, because I feel that we hang on to things and there comes a time where we have to let go, and I feel you've done very, very well with that and continue to do that. Feel that you've made the right choices, because you have, and sometimes we have to let certain, not only situations, but certain people, certain things in the past, and just certain things, you know, just let go. And that helps us to move forward. And it, you know, you seem like you so want to help people. You have such a loving heart. You're a very helping, loving, kind person. You want to take care of everyone, but also remember to take some time for you. I feel that you're very,
that has been an issue.
Yeah, you give so much to yourself that there's really nothing left to give, if that makes sense and you understand what I mean. Because you tend to give so much, and you have so much to give, so much love, so much healing, so much help, caring. It's kind of your nature. But you also do it to the point where sometimes it kind of drains you. So you also kind of take and step back a little bit, and that also goes back to the certain people that sometimes we want to help very, very much, but we can't because they don't want it, or they just aren't ready for it at this time. And it can be very, very difficult, but sometimes we have to, in order to continue to move forward and to help many, there's those certain few that we have to kind of let go or just kind of put on hold for a while. And so I think you know exactly what I'm talking about, and you feel that, and you know that you're making the right choices, because I get that question, kind of wondering and not sure, but you do so well. Follow your heart. Follow your intuition. You're led very strongly there. You pick up emotions. You pick up feelings. You feel a lot in your heart, in your gut, your stomach.
Well, thank you. I was going to say, what you had just said, just confirmation, because I had journaled that about taking care of self. So, yeah, thank you.
Good for you. Yes. Because you are such a loving heart, and you give so much to others, and you need to take time for yourself, you know, do them special things. You know, I get like even special baths, special meditations, special time for you, a spa time, anything, whatever's good and healing. I feel you have a very strong connection with Mother Earth. Animals are a very, very strong connection with you. I keep getting frogs. That might seem odd, but for some reason I keep getting frogs with you, which is very good. It seems like almost kind of a lifetime spiritual connection you've had with many, many animals. You're very healing, very loving with people, but especially with animals. but I get a strong, it's one of your spirit animals is frog.
Oh, well, I'll be darned. All right.
Yes.
I think Stan just posted a frog. Stan,
did
you post a frog?
He might be feeling that as well. Stan's amazing. And yes, he can give you very much information on frog. But I picked that up very strong for you and very wonderful. So watch for everything from pictures to actually seeing them, messages, hearing them, just anything, because I feel that it's a very strong spirit animal for you. So that is something very, very good. Travel. I get you've been very interested in taking some kind of vacation, some kind of you time. It almost seems like you've been putting it off for next year because it feels like finances are an issue or you're concerned
right.
about it. Yeah, but it's something that you need. It's something that you really want. I get water, cruise. Maybe some kind of cruise, water. Water, the element water is a very good connection for you. Very healing,
right.
Very cleansing. Very cleansing for you. I feel that you, because meditation is a little bit difficult right now because your mind wanders and mine does as well, so I completely
yeah.
understand this. And so when that happens, you have to find certain other ways of meditating. For me, a lot of times it's music. It can be working with animals. It can be working with stones. It can be many different things. Water comes in very, very strong for you. It's a very good element. Keep a glass by your bedside even. Work with it each day. Yes, because
okay.
I feel water... I don't know if it's one of your elements that you work with, but you should. If not, it's a very, very strong one. I'm fire, but I work with all of them, and elemental energy is amazing, very healing, very wonderful. So keep a glass by your bedside. When you cleanse, when you bathe, when you take a shower, when you take a bath, look at it as a very healing process. Look at it as a cleansing process because you tend to hold a lot of stress, a lot of energy, a lot of from helping so many. You hold a lot in. And a good way to release it is with the water element. It's very cleansing. So when you shower or you take a bath, a good way that I do and I recommend for many people is to take and let all that water, all that element help get rid of all that stuff. All that stuff that we have built up, all that negative, all that, you know, just impure, all that things that we're dealing with, and watch it all go down the drain.
Mm-hmm.
You know, say goodbye to it. Watch it all as it runs and circles down the drain. Look at it as it's all leaving you. You know, look at it as a good, positive way. I feel that that's going to be, especially showers, baths as well, which there's many different things you can do from essential oils to many healing, you know, salts. Even if you like bubbles, bubbles make people happy, you know, but baths can be very good, but showers too. And when you do that, watch that water drain and let it take away. Because I feel you need that release. Work on that release because you tend to hold a lot in. I pick it up. I feel it.
Okay.
I feel that you almost have a hard time breathing at times, you know, because you hold so much in. A lot of times we'll tend to kind of put that bubble of protection and you know, keep that up around us. But we also, there's times where we have to remember to let it down, let go of everything, and then put it back up. But there's times where we have to release and let go of so much, and that's something for you that just I think is going to be very beneficial and help you. So kind of try to remember to do that a little bit more.
Okay, I will.
Yeah, I think it's going to make you feel much lighter. It's going to lighten your load, you know, take that, make you breathe easier, because I just get a little bit hard time breathing and I feel it almost like a weight on your chest. And those little things, you know, even if it's music, a certain way is meditate. I get meditation that's going to be very helpful for you. Travel. Now, keep that in mind. Your trip. Safe work.
All right, I know.
Just probably getting ready for the crickets. But keep that travel in mind, because I know that's a dream of yours, and it's something that I almost get Netherlands, Norway.
Well, we're Norwegian, our family, on my father's
perfect.
Side, so.
So am I. So perfect, yes. So it's a dream for me to go there as well, so keep that as a possibility, because I see that as a dream, and I think that you have very deep spiritual connections and ancestry there, and I think that would be just an amazing, wonderful, wonderful place, because I get Norway, I get that so much for you, and so thank you for telling me that, because Norwegian, I picked that up. I am as well.
Yay!
Thank you, Kimber. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. So very welcome. And thank you.
Oh, bye-bye.
Her readings are short. It's the wrap-up that takes 20. Okay. Anyway, thanks.
Sorry.
Good luck. Good luck, Sherry. And happy
I did so much for you.
We'll meet again. Okay. Let's go get Linda.
Oops, yay, Linda.
Okay, now this is Linda. Linda, not Boatman Linda. This is Linda. Hi,
hello.
Linda.
Hi, Kimber.
Hi, Linda. Hi, Linda. Thank you for calling.
Yeah, I was interested. I was reading a little bit about what all the stuff you could do. And I was interested if any chance like of messages, like either by my spirit guide or an angel.
Sure. Yes, definitely. You have
what
many around.
Out?
Oh,
what,
yeah.
Spirit guides or angels?
You have many around you of both, actually.
Cool.
You have many angels around you, and much, much beautiful golden energy. I see bright, bright, beautiful auras around you. You get messages from angels, and I think that sometimes you might not quite acknowledge that they're there. Do you see sparks, almost like little spots of light? Little flashes of,
yes.
Almost like little golden flashes, little stars. I get like around steps in your house, around your bedroom, because they're there, and a lot of times they will show up as that out of the corner of your eyes. I feel you pick them up, you see them, and you feel them around you. Acknowledge them, say hi to them, tell them that you appreciate them being there,
mm-hmm.
because they're around you so much. They tend to give you messages, little things like certain things to protect you. I get very strong protection. Certain things to delay you, even like maybe hiding keys or giving you them a few extra moments so you're not in a certain place or at a certain time. If you feel that, do you understand what I mean? Does that resonate?
Yes,
with
I
you?
Do.
Okay. Because I feel you notice these things, you pick these messages up, and a lot of times you subconsciously go along with them and you understand them. And then you might think back later, but it's something that you've gotten for so long that you pick up on that. If something tells you turn left or turn right, keeps you out of traffic, keeps you out of certain situations, it's to keep you safe, it's to keep you them few extra minutes. Even hiding keys, I feel that they've hid keys from you before to keep you delayed that little bit longer for very good reasons. I feel you pick up on that. You know that. You know that they're around you. You feel that. You feel their energy. You communicate with them, but do it a little more. Be bolder. Does that make sense? Be bolder with them? Be more open?
Yes.
More...
Yeah. Is there any in particular one that really jumps out?
For angels, I get... Actually, Michael, Archangel Michael, is very, very protective, very around you very often. And then Gabriel, I get Gabriel. You have many, many around you, and spirits as well. I get a lot of spirits step forward for you. There's a female energy. She, dark hair, dark eyes. She feels like she passed 30s, late 30s maybe. Almost feels like sister energy. Even if you weren't physically sisters, you feel very close. Be someone that's around you very often with an S name. I don't know why I get like almost Sylvia's. S. Seems almost an S name. Female spirit, though, she comes around often at night. Do you feel someone sit by your bed? I feel you get a lot of spiritual energy at night, that you wake up in the middle of the night at certain times. And almost like you go and you check the clock because you feel like it seems familiar to you. 111333. Certain numbers. Watch for them. They can be messages. They can also. I'm not a real familiar with numerology. I have several friends who are, and they're wonderful at it. But they have certain meanings, and I get 333 and 111 for you.
Okay.
So kind of watch for them numbers to appear. Definitely get
but
pay
threes,
attention.
Right? Threes,
yes, threes, 333. Can sometimes be more or less, but even 33 or but 333 comes in strong, and those are angel numbers. Positive, good numbers. So kind of it seems like you get number sequences. Like I said, I'm not real familiar with numerology, but I know they do have meanings, and 1112, so it just seems like certain numbers kind of catch your eye, kind of, you know, have certain meanings for you, so pay attention for those ones to come up for you as well.
Okay.
Spirits, you also have a lot of animals around you. You have a very deep connection with animals. There's dog spirit around you. It feels like a brown, almost a, not that you used them for hunting, but a hunting type dog. Maybe it be a beagle, a cocker spaniel. Definitely a dog energy around you. It seems almost one that you grew up with and that loved you very, very much. you have a way with animals. You have a deep connection with healing. It seems like you... Have you ever felt like heat in your hands?
The heat? Yeah.
Heat? Yes. Okay, heat. When you touch animals especially, people as well. But I feel you pick up like a heat energy. You have healing hands. I get like Reiki. If you haven't studied Reiki, it might be something that you want to look into. Because I think it's something that you have a very good quality. You have a very high energy with it. You have it in your hands. I get healing hands, and I get the heat.
Cool.
That, yes, heat is a good sensor for you. And try to practice on some animals. Cats, dogs are very wonderful to start out with. For some reason, I get horses. I don't know if you love horses, have worked with horses, or you will work with horses, but I pick up horses with you. But cats and dogs are a good way to start out. Start by feeling their energy. When you go around them, it's something that you've done without even realizing it, but try to work with that and then try to learn some. You know, it's always good to learn, especially what you're drawn to. And even if you give it a shot, give it a try, but I pick up Reiki for you. Stones are very good, and crystals are a good supplemental healing for you. But I feel you're good with animal communication and also with healing them through Reiki-type energy. And you get the heat in your hands, and so when you go through, touch them, feel them, guide your hands through their bodies, watch for that heat, feel that, and you'll feel a certain energy. You'll feel their pain. They'll communicate with you. It's something that it takes a little while to develop, but I feel it very strong with you. And I feel it's something that you've had a connection with animals since you've been young. You've been drawn to them. But I feel almost a need to be around them more, almost like you've been kind of sheltered from them or withdrawn from them, and you need animals in your life, if that makes sense.
Well, what about that healing, like you said, with healing with animals? How about like with people? I was always interested, like that hands-on healing and... You know, to do with the healing?
Yes, yes.
With people too, because that's my biggest interest too.
Perfect. Wonderful. And that's great, because I do feel you're very drawn to that. And with people, very strongly. With animals too, and with animals is something that you've done pretty much your whole life, and I think it's going to get more into people, and you're going to focus more on that, because you do really want to help others. You do really want to help people, and it's something that you're meant to do, and that I almost get like a side business, or just almost even something that you're going to do for your own satisfaction, for your own, just to heal and help others. It's a need of yours, and it's something that you've wanted for a long time, and you're looking for ways of doing that, and you're going to find them. You're going to start to, you know, do it. I feel almost you kind of question a little bit. Don't question, just do it. Just start. You've got to start. Yep, start somewhere. You know, start and see, maybe that's where I get the starting with animals sometimes can be a little bit easier than with people. But I do feel very, very strong Reiki is something to learn with. But the hands, you have the healing hands, you know, a lot of times we have certain areas, you know, and you have a lot of energy in your hands. As we heal others, we heal ourselves, and it's going to help you so much, too. I feel this is a very strong need for you, something you're drawn to and you want to do. You are going to be very good at it, and it's something that you know deep down and that you've wanted to do for a very long time, and you just need to make the steps to do it. So feel confident, feel that this is something that you're meant to do and you need to do, and you're going to help others and you're going to help yourself by doing that as well. So do it, you know. I just feel that it's something that you've wanted to do for so long but just haven't quite been sure. So feel confident, do it, and understand that it's part of you. And that, you know, I feel you get like lack of knowledge, lack of not sure of knowing, but you know. This is so hard.
Yeah.
I'm feeling what you're feeling, and so it's coming to me. But I feel that you know in your heart, and that the more you work on it and the more you're open to it, it's going to just flow. It's going to flow like a river, you know. Look at it that way. It's
okay.
Going to come to you. You have that hidden knowledge already within you, and it's good to learn like everything from, you don't have to spend a lot of money. You can go from certain YouTube videos to books to online classes to tapes, but always make sure that what you do is a good teacher. You'll know, you're going to have many, and you're going to know who you're drawn to, and you'll be drawn to the right ones, because you also, as you learn from them, you pick up their energy as well. So you always want someone good, someone loving, someone kind and caring, and you're going to get that. And follow your heart, you'll know, because you'll have many, many teachers. And you'll teach as well as you go along. It's something that's good. We all help each other in so many ways. And that's, you know, all part of the process. And I just see so many good things. I see you're so willing and ready to learn. You're ready to help others. And, it's something that you want to and you need to do. You're going to be very happy. Do you have the questions?
Oh, you answered. That was very interesting, yes.
Good.
That's it anyway. That's it.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Oh, that was really interesting. Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. And yeah,
The moment that you said you're going to be very happy, I was coloring this.
I can't get in chat, but I can imagine.
Yeah. Well, I was coloring the word happy.
Yay.
Happy.
Yay.
Yeah.
Good.
Oh, stretch. Okay, you're so out of here, Linda. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you,
bye-bye. Linda. Thank you, and much love and luck to you. Thank you.
That's a true story, by the way. True story that I was covering.
Yay! That's good. Because I cannot get in chat.
They're probably going, why? Like, she's having, like, seizures or something. It's like, my headset's starting to go wonky, so the sound is traveling between going from one ear to the next ear, and I just, every time I move my head or something, my headset is, so time for a new headset for me. So anyway, I love this headset and this style. That is a problem with it. The same thing happened to my previous two. It just, and then it starts going really bad, like every 3 seconds. It's like, you know, cutting in and out on me and traveling from one ear to the next. And so, but I prefer this headset because it's light, it's a behind the neck one, and the microphone is flexible, not like just rigidly up and down like them awful. So anyway, they don't make these. So next is, we're going to go to Jay. You just heard a beep in your ear. Who's that?
Hi, it's Jackie.
Oh, Jackie. I don't know why I can't ever remember that, Jackie. You know what I mean?
I know, I'm just not memorable, I guess.
You are.
Yeah, you are. Hey, Jackie.
Hi, Kimber. How are you guys?
Great. How are you?
Good. It's so weird. Like, the two previous callers, I'm like, is she reading me and not them? Like, you know, I don't know. But anyway, the situation is that I did make the plunge. I quit my job, my full-time job, doing an unpaid internship. And I was wondering what the next, you know, several months look like.
Sure. Great. Yes. Wow. A lot of opportunity. A lot of amazing things coming up. Growth. Finances are going to be good. Job opportunities, it seems like you're going to have several. It almost feels like there's going to be a couple fighting for you.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Because my availability is really weird because I'm still going to school. I'm doing my internship. You know, it's like I have a very weird schedule.
Yeah. You seem so busy. But yet, you seem to plan it out well. I get you're a good planner.
Yeah, I try to be.
Yeah, but you do very well with that. I get roll with the punches, if that makes sense.
Yeah, I've had some of those too.
Yeah, I get that, and that I get much good energy. Wow, I willing to work hard. I get a lot of amazing energy and that you're willing to go the extra mile. I get willing to work hard and willing to go the extra mile. Your internship. Now, I see that has been something very beneficial, very good for you, a learning experience. It also has been a good communication, a good way of connecting with people, meeting new people and others, networking. I get that is a good way of networking for you. You jump right in. You, I get you are a little bit shy, but when you need to, you will jump right in and you will push yourself forward, and that's a very good thing. I see that as being a very positive quality, and you know when to do it. You kind of sit back and watch things happen, but you know when the right opportunity to strike mm-hmm. is. And I picture you just sitting back, waiting, and then all of a sudden, boom, there you go, you're ready. And that's something very good. You have a very strong quality with that. You timing. I get timing is essential, and you have very good timing. You seem to get along well with others. You make friends easily. You do well with working with others. That is a quality that gets noticed. And is something that's going to be very beneficial, not only in your internship, but in your job opportunities in the future as well. I do see many. I see three very good possibilities, two that are, like, fighting for you. holidays. I get around the holidays, there's going to be some big changes. Some really good opportunities. Go to the holiday parties. It seems almost like you're torn, you know, between how sometimes we get like, hey, excited, but then no, I don't want to go.
Yes, you know? All the time.
Yeah, and I get both of that with you, but go. Get dressed up just as, you know, as much and just almost wild. Just kind of get dressed up with, I get like a special touch of you, a certain way. There's certain something about you that's going to get you noticed. And go to these holiday parties. I know some are still a little ways off, but plan on them. And like I said, I know that there's that part of us too that sometimes go, oh, I don't really want to go. but you do. Because it's going to be a very good opportunity. I get dressed up and go and have fun. And no, you're going to laugh, but I'm going to tell you anyway because I get it. And because, ask Chris, I will tell you what I get. Buy the special panties. Splurge. Buy them. I will kind of leave it at that. But I see much fun, much holiday excitement. Red is a good color for you, so red lace. But yeah, I see a lot of fun holidays for you. Go to these holiday parties, have fun, open up. You know, I guess there's a wild. Oh.
Can I ask a question about the interview I went to last?
Yes. Oh, you can't hear. Okay. Can you guys hear me?
Hang on.
Okay. It's settled down. There was wacky noise going on, and maybe it was me because that was also during a time when I was trying to speak and couldn't. It was like this. As soon as you said, buy the special pen, you know, and everyone started a lot, like that went. Went crazy. And I'm all like, so. It might have been my end, and so I apologize for it cutting in, but that was a crazy sound. I thought I needed to break it up and try and investigate where it was coming from. So, because I muted myself, the sound didn't go away.
Oh, wow.
And so I don't know that it was really me, and so I needed to just, like, stop whatever was going on, and now I let you go ahead. Sorry, Karen.
No, that's okay. See, that was spirit confirming that you need to buy them special panties.
That's just too funny.
Well, I tell it like it is. I can be kind of a little bit naughty, but hey, you know, if I get it for you, I will tell you.
Funny.
So definitely be prepared because I do see some love in there as well.
Well, I went on a job interview on last week, Thursday, and I was interviewed by two people, and it was kind of like good cop, bad cop type of a thing. And I don't know, like, do you see that working out?
Yeah. You know, I get... That was almost a test. I get that was kind of a test of seeing your response and that you did very, very well. You have a way of communicating, a way with reading people, and you picked that up. So you knew how to go along with it, and you did very well. Your job interview is very good. You intrigued them. You sparked their interest. I do feel that they had several applicants, but yours really stands out. You have a lot of very good qualities. I get, don't be afraid to shine. Feel that you have these special qualities. Feel confident because I get a little bit of hiding yourself almost. Don't hide yourself no more. Push yourself out there. Even when you feel a little bit that it may be a little bit difficult, a little hard to do that, but have confidence and know to just throw yourself out there that you're feeling that for a reason. You do get noticed, especially by doing that, you know, because there's going to be certain times where you need to do that and you're going to know and you're going to feel it. Go with it. I get go with the flow, like a river, you know, just picture a river, picture feeling comfortable with it, because sometimes we want to fight that.
Mm-hmm.
We want to, you know, we feel a little bit either nervous or a little bit not sure or a little bit of just so used to being stuck in a certain place.
Mm-hmm.
And I get, go with the flow, because it's going to bring you to where you need to be. So
okay.
don't be afraid of change, because I get almost a... I don't really want to say fear of change, because you seem almost excited for it, but
mm-hmm.
fear of the unknown. Let that go. Grab it. Realize it. You know, use your wings and fly, because you have so many opportunities, so much going for you. A lot of things, I get doors opening, many doors opening. You, as I said, have opportunities, several different choices to make. So you almost feel like you've struggled and fought for so long to get a chance. But not only are you going to have a chance, but you're going to have several opportunities to pick from. So you're going to finally get what you deserve, because you've worked so hard to get there. And it's going to feel very good for you, and it's going to help you, you know, and know that you've earned it, because you have. You've earned your stripes.
In my internship, they asked me, like, oh, are you ready for a caseload? And I've only been there 2 days. I'm like, no, I don't want to screw anybody up. I'm not ready for a caseload. Like, I don't know what I'm doing yet. And it just, like, it kind of, like, scared the hell out of me.
See, now that's the wrong, I wouldn't say wrong answer, but I would have answered that. So even if you didn't feel ready, I would say, I feel very ready, but I will hope. But as long as I know that I have the ability to consult with somebody should the need arise. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but I don't want to screw anybody else's life up.
Well, I mean, how are you going to do that if you can get guidance from... That's how you learn. You got to take it on.
I want to get my feet wet a little bit more.
Oh, but what I'm saying to you is that if I'm the employer, right?
Uh-huh.
I'd rather have somebody say absolutely, but I'm going to need the confidence to know that I can come to you, or you can assign me somebody that I can, you know, consult with.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm eager and ready to get going, because you know what I mean, like when, because then I'm thinking as an employer, well, when is this person good? You're always going to, even the most experienced ones, right, have
mm-hmm.
those people's lives in their hands.
Right.
And every case, no matter how much or how little experience you have, brings the potential of screwing somebody's life up.
Mm.
Right?
Yeah.
And so all I'm saying is that the message you want to send to a potential employer is, heck yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And you just got to do it. You know, I'm just saying. Anyway, I'll shut up now.
No.
Yeah, no. You're so right, Chris, though. You know, that is perfect and perfect advice, because you do. You just got to go with it. And as much as we think a lot of times, oh, no, you know, I got to wait for the perfect answer. I got to wait for the perfect time. I got to wait to make sure I do it right. And we're always waiting. And no, don't do that. Understand and have confidence and say, I'm feeling it for a reason. I'm going to throw it out there, because even sometimes, just like I said, just like the panties, you know, I'll get things and I will throw them out there. I will tell you and let you know.
Okay.
You're right. Feeling it for a reason. So
okay.
Trust
okay.
yourself.
All right. Thank you so much.
Yes,
at least
thank you.
Jack. Okay.
Yeah, I know Chris is doing an unusual cricket bit there, but I totally get it.
All right, have a good night, you guys.
Thanks.
Thank you, and you too.
All right.
All right.
Thank you
so
for
now
calling.
We got one, two, buckle my shoe, and a third person jumped on. So you got like
Yay.
A half, ten minutes each. 10 minutes each.
Sure, and I'll stay late too, so you know.
Who is the person I'm gonna open up? You're gonna hear a beep in your ear, and you'll know that that's you. Who's this?
Hi, Chris. This is Anna.
Hi, Anna. What's up? You got a question?
I also we're all on the same track of kind of wanting to know financially and what's coming up for the next few months and financial and health wise for me.
Sure.
And I want to say, when I heard the cricket just before, I just had to laugh. I know that you said you were going to use the cricket, but I heard it loud and clear. And my ex used to call me Cricket, so it just kind of was like a light.
Cool.
Cute. Cricket. Yes, that's a great nickname for you. That makes sense, then, why I'm picturing this. Okay. It almost feels that not only was that a nickname for you, but that's also kind of a spirit animal for you as well. I get a lot of change with you right now. It seems like you've really worked on a lot of spiritual growth. Finances. Finances are going to change for you for the better. It seems like you've kind of struggled for some time, kind of a difficult situation, and you've been going through some things financially, and your finances are going to get better, especially by the end of the year, but next year is going to be a way better financial year for you. A lot of changes, some issues that you're going to be able to work out and finalize. I get like finalizing paperwork, legal work, some kind of documents, something that's going to kind of bring an end to some issues that you've been concerned or working on. And that is going to bring a much better financial year for you next year. New changes. It almost seems like a big move. I'm not sure if it's physically actually moving. It almost seems more like a growth movement, big changes, some different things in your life that you've been working towards. This year is going to be paying off for a lot of hard work that you've done. It seems almost, have you been working on paying off financial education loans?
Not education loans, just basic loans.
Basic loans. Okay, because, yeah, I get, like, some paying off some loans, some finances. Maybe it's some education that you're going to do, because I get some classes, almost like a spiritual nature, some classes that you're going to take. And it seems like you're a little worried about, because you have other financial obligations. But I do feel that they're going to be very beneficial and very helpful. Additional to your regular work, I feel that you're going to pick up some kind of part-time, almost like a self-employment. Maybe that's where the spiritual work, spiritual classes are going to come in. Because it feels that you're going to come up with some kind of side way to make a little extra money to help with some bills. Because I do feel that you've had some financial issues that are going to work out September, October, November. But by the beginning of next year, a lot of your finances are going to change. I get almost like another part-time job. Are you working full-time right now?
No, I'm not.
No? Okay, because are you looking full-time or part-time right now? Because it seems like you've been looking for a job.
I haven't been looking for a job. I've been in a very long-term healing process, so I haven't been able to work. But
okay.
I was playing with the idea of, I make jewelry, and it's just, for many years I have, and I haven't been doing much of it at all, but I was thinking about putting some online.
Do that, because I get, you're very creative, and it almost seems like a spiritual type jewelry, that you not only make it and create it, but you put, like, spiritual energy into it. Some kind of either... stone energy or some kind of healing energy, Reiki infused, something. But I get, like, a part-time job, self-employment, look into that, because I think that might be something that you're going to work on, and it seems like come spring that you're going to start it this year, and in the beginning of the year it'll start to grow, but like spring it's going to start to grow a lot more, and it'll start to reap some financial benefits. It seems almost at first that it's kind of getting out there, but that don't worry, because the finances will come in, but at first you got to kind of just get known and get out there. You do have an amazing creativity to you. I feel you spend a lot of nights up and thinking. Your mind's always creating different things, picturing different things, making very beautiful jewelry. Stones, pearls, I just get a lot of natural elemental energy into your jewelry. I almost get like a Native American type of jewelry, feathers, stone energy. I get you put so much of yourself into it. You have a very creative flair. Fire, I don't know, do you work with fire? Because for some reason I get fire with you. Whether you work with it or it's your birth element, fire.
Well, she's hot-headed.
She's what?
I have Sag rising, Sag Mercury, Aries moon, but I'm a Capricorn sun.
Okay.
So I have a lot of fire.
Yes, you are fire. I get fire very strong with you. In fact, one of my favorite songs is I Am Fire, and I get that with you. That is a very strong element, that an earth as well. Earth and fire are very strong for you, but fire is also a creative spark for you. It ignites things. When you feel almost the need to create, and I get a lot of times you stay up late,
mm-hmm.
You can't sleep, light a candle. Concentrate on the fire, you know, or if you can, a fire pit outside is even better to connect with Mother Earth and to connect and have that fire. But watch the colors. Lose yourself in the fire, because so much creativity is going to come to you from that. It's a very strong element for you. I get you work with it very strongly, and if you haven't, you need to, because it's going to be very, very beneficial for you. It's going to help you so much. It gives you the spark, the energy, because I feel almost at times you feel a little bit drained. And whether you work with it, just like I do, even if it's to light a candle and just watch it, to, you know, be around fire, it brings us so much energy, especially if you're a fire person, and I do feel that is for you. Very, very strong element. So everything from candles to fireplace to fire pits to just, you know, focusing on the different colors. But the element of fire is very strengthening, very healing, very strong for you. So that's a very good one to work with. Snake. I get snake for one of your animals. Your spirit animal, transformation, transmutation, shedding skin. I get you're almost creating anew. You're letting go of old. So snake is one to watch. Snake is one for you. A very, very good creative, very healing, very medical. A very good one for you. So I heard the crickets. You have any quick questions?
We have a couple more and 15 minutes. So I want to give at least 10 minutes to each person. You know what I mean? So.
Yep. And I'll stay after. So.
I got you.
You can always call me back.
For sure. She's here every 2 weeks, and you can get her at her Facebook page, Kimberly Psychic Medium 1. You can find that link on the show page description, okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Donna.
Okay.
Thank you. Take care. Okay, sorry, guys, but that's what it, that actually went 11 minutes, and so...
I'm sorry.
Okay. No, I'm just trying to say I'm trying to be fair to everyone as well. See, and if you call, you know, what I'm trying to get at, and I said at the beginning of the show, like, I'm going to time budget based on who's in there at the beginning. And if people straggle in late, then it cuts down the remaining people's time. You know what I mean? And so that's the way it's, the early bird gets the longer reading on nights at Kimber's here, you know? We're going to go get Mr. Stan the Man. Hey, Stan.
Yeah, well, I signed in as soon as I got here, but that's okay.
I know.
Anyway. Kimber, I haven't talked to you in a while, but yesterday was the hard question, and today's the easy question. So I just want to know about directions. Tell me about which directions I'm going.
Sure. And I'm so happy to talk to you. Thank you so much.
And do you mean literally north, south, east, or west? And
of course. Yes, Chris. Yes.
No, but I mean, because either with Kimber, you're going to get,
can give me whatever she gets, but I just want to know about directions.
There you go.
Yes. Well, with you, I get many directions. I get north, which is...
There we go.
Yes, I get north, exploring, winter. I get snow... animals and sun. Almost a trip for you coming up. Some kind of have you ever been to Canada?
Yeah, I've been to Canada quite a bit, but not lately. I used to go to Canada every year.
Okay, because, yeah, it almost feels like you're drawn there, that you've been either thinking about it or feeling just a northern trip. Mountain lion keeps coming in for you. I don't know why, but mountain lion keeps coming in very, very strong. I just get purr. Purr. yeah, definitely. I get mountain lions, so wherever they have them up north, and Canada for some reason comes in very as a place that you've seen but almost excited to go see again, kind of on your list of things to do. So that might be something that you might want to check into. And it seems and feels like a winter time vacation because I get the snow, I get mountain lion, that connection. With you, I get so much spirits around you. You are just so, they're so drawn to you because you pick them up, you communicate with them well, both people and animals. You are a very, very strong spiritual communicator. You get many messages. You give them, you share them freely, and which is a wonderful, wonderful gift you share. You,
thank you for that.
Yes, and thank you for doing that because I've known you for some time and you have an amazing gift with that. And especially animals are just so, you have a very deep connection, not only spiritually but physically. I get you see them, you see through them, you feel them, you connect with them, you see what they see. Feel what they feel. Yeah, I get that so strong with you. You are very good with people, but you have just such an amazing animal communicator, communication, and just a very special heart. They're very drawn to you because you have this special kindness, a very sweet soul. And that I know from knowing you, but also just from feeling you. I feel it so strong with you.
Well, thank you.
You, yes, thank you. You know,
so there's a, so there's a cougar in Canada. Is that what you're telling me?
Yes, there is a cougar in Canada for you. Yes.
Oh,
a wild one.
I could be in trouble here. I don't know.
Well,
yeah.
That would mean like she's 90 or something.
No.
No, she's a very pretty cougar.
A pretty cougar, okay.
Yep, I can hear her purr now. Yeah, no, I get you are a very special catch. You are a very sweet soul. You have so much love to give, so much to offer. You help many. You always have, you know, in so many different ways, from readings to just being a very good friend, a loving soul, a caring person. You're all about helping others. You're all about love. You're very drawn to certain people, but you are very open and willing and give everyone a chance. You're so non-judgmental. You are very open to everyone, from their spiritual beliefs to their personal beliefs to you just have so much kindness. It radiates from you. I just get like this golden bright light. Very beautiful, beautiful, warm, loving light off of you. Very cool.
My ego is going to be ruined here. You know that, don't you? she's trying to spoil me, Chris, is what she's doing.
Yeah. Well, I'm giving you what I get.
You're buttering me up for something here. I know. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. Canada was one of the places I was thinking about when I gave you the directions. You know, so that was very good. And I know you're running late, so you can call me and just tell me that same thing you just tell me all the time, so that's okay.
Yes. Oh, I would love to. Yes, I will definitely. I'll give you a personal reading. Because I also I get Montana with you and Wes.
Montana, oh, wow.
Yes.
Yeah, yep. I haven't been out there for a long time, you know, quite a while. But, Canada's, I've been pushing to Canada again lately because I haven't been there for a couple of years. And, you know.
Ever since that incident, he hasn't been back.
No, you know what, it's the travel restrictions between countries. I used to go to Canada all the time, you know, I'd be up there 3-4 times a year, actually. And since they, you know, all this stuff went on, more checking at the border and all that stuff, there's a lot of delays and everything, you know, quite often. And, you know, to make it as easy as it did in the past, that's all.
And thank the Americans for that.
Well,
yeah.
Thank everybody, you know, but it's the world we live in, so what are you going to do? But anyway, thank you so much. I won't hold you. I know you got another caller, so I won't even wait for the crickets.
All right. Yeah.
I see. I have good timing. Thanks, both of you. I enjoyed the show. Thanks.
Thanks, Stan. Thank you.
Love you, Stan.
Let's go find out Lorraine. Is it Lorraine?
Yes. This is Lorraine. Hi, Chris. Hi, Kimber.
Hey, Lorraine.
Hi there. Hey, I am. I'm here with my husband and. We're wondering about a move in the near future and if we can sell our house.
Yes. I definitely get selling your house is going to go well. You're going to get several offers, and you're going to get more than what you were hoping for is what I pick up. Yeah, I get more than what you were looking for, so that's going to be good. Three are going to be interested in it, more than that, but three are going to be very serious buyers. You're going to go with the one that's going to be the most beneficial for you and give you a very good price, and it's going to go to a good home, because I almost get that you worry about it going to a good home, and it will. It's something that you put a lot of energy into this place and into this home, and you feel almost a personal thing about it that you want to see it go to someone that's going to love and appreciate it as you did, and it will. You're going to make some money off of it. It has been a good investment for you, and I do see a move in your future and to somewhere you're going to be much happier at. That this place has been good for you. It's served its purpose, though. And you're ready for change. You're ready for something different, something new. I don't know why, but I get ocean. I don't know. Ocean just comes to mind. I don't know if it's either where you're going to live or it's going to be a vacation, but for some reason ocean popped up for you, so that might be something that you might want to look into, either if it's going to be where you're going to live or a vacation. But I do see ocean, I see water, I see sand, beach.
Wonder if it's more like a river. Does it look like an ocean or a river?
Could
Well, you know, river means movement. River means change. So, you know, do you go pray by the river? Because I do pick up a very strong river connection with you. Almost that it's a place that you go connect with. Could be where you end up living by, because I do see water. May it be ocean. I see some form of water. I could be river. I get you go pray by the river, and if you don't, then do it, because okay. It's going to be very, very helpful for you. That's something that I do very often. It's a very good place to go pray. It's a good place to connect, and also to realize that life is flowing, and to look at it as a river, and to understand that to flow with it is much easier than to fight it or to try to go against it. So definitely I do pick up river, a very sacred place for you. It feels almost even in a past life, it's been a very deep connection for you. So yeah, do look at river. I feel even next time you're at a river, look for a special stone. There's going to be a stone that's going to be for you. I don't know if you work with you work with stones, but you should.
I find many, many heart rocks. I do a lot of walking and jogging, and I find a lot of heart rocks.
Good. See, I love those. I'm all about stones, and I always have been, and I am drawn to them, connected to them. They speak to me. I have to have them. And the heart ones are very, very special. And see, you're drawn to them.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Collect them. You have a big heart. I get that with you. And, you know, there's certain ones that we're drawn to. And one of the hardest things is, like, if I go down a dirt road and there's, like, stones everywhere, because it's like, yeah. Oh, no.
I experience that every time.
Yeah. So you know exactly what I feel and what I mean, you know, but certain ones were like, ooh, that one. And it's because it's their energy. It's their calling to us. They're speaking to us. It's their certain ones. So I do feel a very strong stone and crystal connection with you. To also work with healing for you, very helpful for you, a good connection, a good meditation, so go with what you're drawn to, because you don't have to go spend a bunch of money and go buy any. Go out and find them, because they'll find you as well. And so, yeah, collect your stones. Find those ones, because I feel that with you. Even if you look up, like, some online information on certain ones that you're drawn to, because it's not always the prettiest or the most certain beautiful or shiniest. It's what we're drawn to and what we need and what is meant for us. And so go with that. Go with what you're feeling. May it be at a store or out, just out and about, river, lake, field, just all different places, you know, a road full of rocks. And go with the certain ones, you know. I would end up with pockets full.
Actually, I do. I have rocks all over in my plants and everywhere that I have found. And my husband brings me all plants or rocks.
Good, yes. Because I feel a very strong connection with the stone people for you. That's very, very good.
Kimber, does it show a timeline of when we would sell?
Yeah, you know, I'm picking up like 3 months.
Okay.
That would be September, October, November, December. Yes, because I get by the end of the year, over the holiday time, really emphasize your place. You have a beautiful place. You have so much love that you've put into it. So when you go to show it, do like baking. May it be baking cookies or putting on a... Yeah, I get that with you. The homey feel is going to help to sell your place. That just so much love and so much homey feel to it. And so bake cookies, put on a pot of tea, you know, them certain spices, them especially over the holidays. But, you know, it's going to go to a very good home. Someone is out there that's meant for this place, and they're going to give you more than what you were hoping even. And it's, I do see within a few months, I see by next year, the end of this year and the next year, you're going to be in your new place. It's going to be amazing energy. Something different. This place has been very good for you. It's been very nice, but it served its purpose, and it's time for you to move on.
And the move will be good for my husband and I.
Yes, very good. I feel it's going to be very positive, both physically, emotionally, spiritually, even financial. I feel it's going to be a better financial situation for you. Almost like downsizing a bit, but in a very good, positive way.
We need to downsize a lot.
Yes. Okay, because that's what I'm getting. It's going to be much more affordable and practical and better for you. Put it that way. This is going to be perfect for you. What you had has been great, and it served its purpose.
Okay.
But it's time it's time for change. I see great and amazing things. I see it being a much more positive, like the next step, you know. I feel it's going to be much more affordable. It's going to be downsizing. It's going to be more practical and fitting for you, and that you and your husband are going to be very, very happy. That you have a very...
Yeah,
bye.
Oh, my Lord.
Tired
and wants to go to sleep.
Yeah.
No,
she's all caught up on Candy Crush.
When it gets all, unicorns and rainbows, I can't help myself but to play Kumbaya.
Yeah.
I get too mushy and
you guys gotta actually put it on the market, you know, before you start to ticker, eh?
Oh yeah.
When people spend, I'm all like, well, when are you gonna pack? You know, when am I gonna move? Well, when are you gonna pack? You know what I mean? When am I gonna sell my house? When are you gonna put it up on the market? You know what I mean?
Guess my question was, we weren't sure if we would sell it if we even tried, and that was kind of our, you know, what we wanted to hear. So
So all I'm saying is, you know, like with the 3 month thing, or with, you know, like the ticker, well, if you decide not to put it till spring, then, you know, then of course, so it's all of these things are dependent upon your actions at this point.
Okay. I will take all of that into consideration.
All right. Very good. Well, thank you. Good luck.
And thank you, Chris. And thank you, Kimber. I appreciate your time.
Thank you so much. And I wish you so much luck. And I think you're going to do very, very well over the holidays. It's a perfect time for you. Get busy, sell it, and it will all go very, very well for you. You will find what you're looking for.
Okay. All righty. Well, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
All right. You take it easy. So I have I have a question from somebody. I'm not going to say who or anything like this, and it's just more expeditious to answer in this way. And it's to say, how would a white person, you know, approach a native shaman for assistance in interpreting a certain thing that has happened or experiences that they've had? And in almost all cases, you know, the deal is that with, especially if they're elders or whatnot like this, then, you know, at the very minimum, first of all, find out what tribe are they from. You know what I mean? And then try and educate yourself as to the methods of approaching. In other words, in some, you know, it's just as simple as bringing tobacco or some other gift. Some gift now, what would the gift be? It's not a Walkman. You know what I mean? It's not a, oh, Walkman, I just dated myself. Where did that come from? You know what I mean? But like, you know, like it could be even something like maybe walk. Like a walking stick, or that would be very unique. That would be a very unique gift. But what I'm trying to get at is that if you try to find out a little bit about what tribe they're from, what would some of their traditions, and there's a plethora of information available online, but at the very least you want to approach with tobacco just for the ability to sit down and talk, to ask your question. And then at that point, it's not of any harm to say, what would there be some gift I could offer you to so you offer tobacco to begin with, to have the can I ask you a question? I'd like to ask you a question. Then you say, is there any gift or anything that I can offer you? Because I need assistance interpreting some experiences that I've had. And that, I think, would, you know, because I think that at least if they think that you're honoring and respecting their time and their tradition, that they will, you know, you would be received more warmly than if you just said, hey, you know, blah, 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 this happened to me. What do you think about that? And so that's my best advice on that. I hope that the answer, do you have anything to add to that, Kimber?
Oh, I totally agree with you. You know, I definitely have the most respect and honor for all shaman and, you know, all their amazing abilities and helpfulness. And I have found them to be everyone that I have known so wonderful, so caring, loving, and helpful, and just so open, honest, and non-judgmental. And you know, I've even have said, hey, you know, this might seem like a, you know, not the smartest question or not the greatest question, but, you know, I need to ask, or I, you know, and I have found them to be so open, honest, and loving, very caring, always willing to help.
Also, if you're going to shake hands, you want to go with a gentle handshake. The premise of that is that most Native people believe the heart is in the palm of the hand, and you're crushing their heart if you go in for the white man's firm handshake. And easy, yeah, on the direct eye contact. White people think that that's the way that you convey honesty and forthrightness and all of this kind of thing. If you think about the animal world, it can often be seen as disrespect or confrontation. And so, not to say don't look them in the eye, but like you don't want to hold the gaze, and you're showing respect if you kind of, you know, don't do that. And give them time to speak, because generally speaking, they're not like me. And so, like, I am definitely a white communicator. You know what I mean? And that's like, blah, 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 blah. And it's, if they're silenced, keep talking, you know, and allow there to be silence, because it could be that there's more that they're thinking to say, and that they're, you know, being careful in the way that they're going to communicate what they want to communicate to you. Just go with honesty and sincerity. if you try your best to make yourself aware of whatever customs, you know, I don't mean get a 20-year degree on, you know, the Dakota people or the Lakotas or the Cherokees or whoever, you know what I mean? But it's always good when you at least are showing that you've made the effort to care about what, you know, what their people are about, you know? So that's what I'll say about that. So we're in overtime.
Yeah.
I want to share with you guys a song that Bob shared with me yesterday. He knows me well enough, and I really like this song, and I don't know if I'm the last person on earth to hear this song or if this is a new song for most of us. I'm going to play it, and then we'll come back and we'll do overtime. So here you guys go. It's just over 3 minutes. Routes, and it's called Nothing More. Very good song. It's on YouTube. I love the message. I'm really a little bit of a suck that way. And when I was a kid, you know, I was a hard ass kid and everything like that. But the music I was listening to was like Anne Murray. You know what I mean? Like, and it was funny because when I I know, right? When I was at my last job, and at first when I started there, I was like in a cubicle city, right? And so the person that sat beside me was like, looked like the goody two shoes, you know what I mean? And then there was me, the hard ass, you know, rebel. And then the funny thing is that the music that they love to listen to is like Eminem, and I'm like Enya. You know what I mean? And it was like so funny. The two of us were like, if you were to say which person is an Eminem, Eminem is listening to Eminem and which person is listening to Enya, you would have totally guessed the other way around. You know what I mean? And so I do love music that has a message, and I always preferred like the folk stuff and the, you know, the stuff where you could actually understand the lyrics. So anyway, Stan came on, and if anyone else is coming on, Mary Margaret, Kimber's still with us, Stan is there. If anyone else is coming, feel free. And but I do like that song. Bob picked a good one. He sent it to me the other day, so yesterday when he was around. So
I like John Denver too.
Yeah,
I
John Denver.
I'm a dork.
That's Lizzie Starr is all about John Denver.
No, I didn't feel the earthquake, Chrissy.
No, hey.
No. Couldn't feel it.
Yeah, I always thought Lizzie was married to John Denver at one point, so.
Yeah, she's all of Denver, all about John Denver. It was never hard if I was going to have her on. I just wish that she'd get her ass back to North America so I could get her on my, so she's back over there in UK, which means 3 o'clock in the morning is when my show's on for her, you know? And so it makes it really tough for me to book anybody from the UK. Yeah, I can always tell how desperate they are to get on a show by how willing they are to come on my show.
Oh. Silly.
In the morning. Well, no, I'm just saying it's 3 o'clock in the morning for them.
Oh,
Yeah, you know what I mean? So, I've had some people go, oh, that's okay, that's okay, that's not a problem. Like, those are people highly motivated to be on the radio for a reason, you know, sell a book or whatever, you know what I mean? And so I don't even usually ask UK people for that reason. Just too late, too early, late or too early for them, you know?
I'm a night owl.
Yeah.
I've always been.
You have, eh? Mm-hmm. I've always been an early riser, even when I was a young kid. And, you know, I've been getting like a five hour, even all the years I worked in that, I'd usually be about a midnight to bed and 5 a.m. up, you know. And now, again, like I say, without a reason to get up, but there's no reason to. Half the time when I go force myself to lay down in the afternoon, it's because I worry that if I don't, like, come around 6 p.m. I'm just going to be and I'm supposed to be on the air in 2 hours, and so I kind of, you know, I have, for that reason, I have a reason to be up by 8 p.m. by 6 p.m. my time, so that means that I kind of have to force myself in by the early afternoon or mid-afternoon at the latest to at least try. But otherwise, if I didn't do a radio show, I don't know when I don't even know what my routine would be like then, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
At least it gives me some kind of a structure, somewhere to be, like, you know, cause without that, they do say, like, people do much better with our schedule and a routine.
Mm-hmm.
And, kids for sure. But, you know, I think really all people do. And I think our bodies also appreciate a routine, you know. And this is something that, like, again, without that, you know, like, if you have a family, so then you've got things that they have to do on schedule, so that you are on their, you know, for that purpose you're a little bit on their schedule too, if you have kids, of course, you know. But when you're single and without a job, you're kind of like, whatever, I guess I'll sleep when I sleep. So lots of storms and earthquakes, I guess, happening over there.
They had one in Oklahoma, too. The one that will get us will be the New Madrid Fault that's down by our farm. That's the one they've had us pack away supplies for and everything so many times. Remember the guy, I can't remember his name, he said we were going to have an earthquake, blah, 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 on such and such a day, and everybody was all putting their stuff in kits and stuff, and then that day passed and nothing happened, and then the earthquake hit, you start thinking, well, you know, that stuff's not going to stay good, so you take a little out and a little more out, a little more out, and then there's nothing left in the kit.
Yeah. No, and you know what happens, right, is people, they get complacent with, because with all the warnings and then nothing really happened, and I think that's what happened, like, to a lot of, like, the, what was the one, the really bad one that hit New York and then the one New Orleans and all, like, they were all, like, you know, people were deciding not, and same with some people that decide to not leave, you know, when there's a fire, forest fire thing, you know?
Yeah.
And they just, you know, I think that in almost all cases, I would definitely be packing up and getting out of Dodge. I'm grateful, you know, I mean, with all of the, it is a pain in the ass to live where it's so cold for so much of the year or whatever, but we have really been, you know, we're pretty much, we don't really get, we get tornadoes now and then, you know what I mean? Now and then. We had one bad one. We weren't even tornado prepared, us in Edmonton. And so when we got hit by a tornado, that was a freaking rude awakening. I didn't even know. There I am out on the deck looking, look at that big mofo freaking tunnel. Holy crap. I'm like, you know, didn't like feel the need to run down to a basement or get in a bathtub or anything like that. And we just weren't tornado trained, you know. So severe thunderstorms, and that's really about it. We don't have to run from lava. We don't have earthquakes. We don't have hurricanes. We don't have tsunamis. We don't have any of that. So I feel pretty lucky in that way. And I couldn't imagine living the kind of stress that, like, every year, like, is this a year my house is going to get wiped out by a hurricane or by a tornado? Or what I mean? Like, that would just be way too freaking stressful. And how many people am I going to lose this year because of violent weather or something like that, you know?
Yeah. Well, you just have to respect the weather, and you can't get too complacent.
I remember, you know, one year we had a caller call in. What was the name of the one that hit New York that was really bad?
Sandy.
Sandy, that's right. So we had a caller called into my show, actually had been somebody that was on a Teresa Caputo episode, and her fiance had, gotten, during the storm or whatever, went outside to do something and a tree fell on him and killed him. And she was so, this was a very good example of, how to be and not be for a reading. You know what I mean? And the woman was so closed off and angry and hostile and everything else. Like, she just wasn't listening. She just wasn't, you know, it wasn't conducive to a great reading. And Teresa was extremely patient with her. And that person actually wound up calling into my show one day. And as soon as I started to hear her story, I said, that sounds familiar. You know what I mean? Were you on the what's it called, Long Island Medium? And sure enough, and I saw that episode, and I told her, I said, you were really a little bit angry and closed off during that, you know. And so it's just funny what a small little, who's gonna, like, if I'm paying $700 or $800 to Teresa Caputo, I'm going in as an open book and I'm keeping my mouth shut. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, my money's worth out of this reading. You know what I mean? I'm not going to sit there and yell and get all mad and angry and be all like that. You know, or else it's not the right time to get a reading when you're that way. You know what I mean? I think that you need to be able to, I just don't think that it's conducive to go in all angry and combative to get a reading, especially one that you paid almost $1,000 for, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you have to be a little open anyway, you know.
Deb, can you unmute, or do you want me to, or what are you doing? Deb, with your beautiful haircut.
I'm here.
Hi, Deb.
Hi. Well, I talked to my other friend on Skype today who always used to cut my hair. And she's in Yellowknife. And she agrees it's a shitty haircut. And,
or someone else was just like, oh, who cut your
hair? Wait a minute. You talked to her on the phone and she agreed without seeing
you? Oh, Skype. Skype video. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. But I'm like, oh, my God, I was trying to figure out how I could get to Yellowknife and get this thing fixed. Oh, well, it'll grow.
Oh, you should have seen me when I went to get my hair reverse frosted when I was younger, and I worked. I left that place. She had me turned away from the mirror. And when I turned, she turned me back around, and she started, my hair was long, and she started curling it under in this little weenie way. And I had speckles on the top of my head. It looked like I was a Dalmatian.
Oh, a Dalmatian.
And the phone rang, and I said, all I could think of was getting home and fixing my hair before I had to go to work. And so I
forgot. I'm just going to quickly thank the archive for the shirt and Hillary Black.